Going inside. We are in the living room. For a widower, the room seems rather tidy. I'm quite impressed. Don't you ever shut up? Are you programmed to evaluate my personal life too? My duty is to support you and observe that you are properly carrying out your responsibilities as a junker. Some observer. You mean informer, right? Well, one could put it that way. Great. Around the room. There's nothing unusual. Everything is in its place. How can you know that? I was provided with complete data files on your apartment. I see nothing noteworthy here. Well, geez, I'm sorry I lead such an ordinary life. Please do not get upset. You know that is not what I meant. I'm not upset, I'm just being sarcastic. Shelf. Gillian, there's a photograph on the shelf. Yes, that's a very special picture for me. There's nothing else on the shelf. What, there's no elf on the shelf? There's a single sofa bed. Overall, a rather Spartan and bland room. Hey, I don't have time to go shopping yet, alright? Just the right amount of space for someone living alone. It's a picture of Jamie. Ah yes, the wife you are separated from. She's very attractive. Come to think of it, I wrote Jamie's video phone number on the back of the picture. I guess I have to investigate to do that. It seems to be a picture of her when she was rather young, but I can't remember when it was taken. She's very young in this picture, perhaps in her teens. She still looks like such a little girl. Hint, hint. I have to investigate. No interest in women. That is most unfortunate. You shut up! Can't believe I'm hearing this from a robot. Ah, yes. I sense the sorrow of the lonely man. Still, there must be some reason why this fellow is leaving alone, even though he is over 30. This will work out just fine. You're going to be doing the housework from here on out. What? Did you say something? What a wonderful apartment you have here. There's nothing unusual here. In fact, it is downright dull. Of course it is. It's my apartment. I lead a very dreary life. There's some numbers written on the back. 393444. It seems to be a video phone number. 393444. Jamie! And we will call her shortly. Yes, that's a number for Jamie's apartment. Why don't you try giving her a call? Would you let me handle my own personal life? This is why I repeatedly look at this stuff, guys. It's an instant photograph of the kind seen in the latter part of the last century. Oh, this is a Polaroid, then. Based on the analysis of the inks and chemical structure of the developers, I would say that it is at least 30 years old. Jamie's number. Gillian, why don't you give your wife a call once in a while? This appears to be the logo of the Moscow Olympics. Wait a minute. The last time the Olympics were in Moscow was way back in... well, before the catastrophe. At the end of the last century, wasn't it? This photograph appears to be a composite. Composite? You mean somebody made it? And the music stopped. It seems unnatural somehow. 30 years ago. Composite? And at the Moscow Olympics on top of that. Perhaps this has something to do with her past. Why would anybody want to make a composite photo? I don't understand. Place took good care of that picture. Hmm. I was thinking maybe we should take the photo, but... Alright, let's... Is there any other rooms in this apartment? Enter bathroom. Alright. We are in the bathroom. It appears to be a very standard bathroom. A low-cost, energy-conserving unit-type sink and shower has been installed. Low cost? Well, excuse me. Sink. There's a bottle of perfume and a razor. There's a small sterilizing unit and a hand dryer. This toilet has the latest Health Pot physical fitness analyzer installed. Wow, I didn't realize I had some of this stuff. I haven't lived here very long, you know. Perfume? It's Jamie's favorite perfume. It's almost as if her scent still lingers in the air. She'll be back. Someday. I promise you, Gillian says. Razor? It's the latest micro laser feather type. Gillian, why don't you try shaving? The floor and walls are all tile covered. There's a separate shower next to the bathtub. The sink is completely normal. Use it with confidence. Metal, would you stop being so bloody analytical all the time? I can't help it. After all, I am an analysis robot. I see nothing out of the ordinary. The pipes aren't even clogged. The Health Pot Physical Fitness Analyzer is the latest in health technology. When using the toilets, a system will measure and analyze your temperature, blood pressure, pulse, urine, and stool to create an instant profile of your current physical fitness level. Oh, jeez. What do you think, Gillian? Why don't you give Health Pot a try? Oh, we can do something? Use bath. Alright. This will be interesting. Let's look, investigate the perfume. Ah, this is that famous Le Smell de l'Amour. That's right, it's Jamie's favorite. This will give you the closest, most comfortable shave a man can experience. Smell? Ooh, Jamie. Does the scent remind you of her? No. Nothing. He thinks, whoops, got caught in a sentimental moment there. Nice scent. Let's shave. Hey, I think I'll shave. Look at how much it took off. And you just shaved with your regular razor this morning, didn't you? That's funny. I've always been happy with that brand. Perhaps we should lay off the old jokes for now. You're right. Think I'll try shaving again. Ooh, that's better. Alright. We'll be done after this, guys. Seriously. Shaving. Oh, my throat was dry. Feel better now, Gillian? Yeah, and more handsome, too. Seriously, he says something different every time. Let me try one more time. Yow! A little too much shaving, I guess. Where's the toilet paper? I better quit. Any more of this and my face will be a moonscape. Let's use the bathroom. That's right. I've had to go for some time now. Metal, would you excuse me? Ah, that's much better. Oh my, Gillian, according to the health pot system... What? What's it say? You're a healthy guy. Wah! What's wrong? The nanomachines I injected in you. What happened? They go sailing right on through? What a waste. Those things are very expensive, you know. Hey, what can you do? What goes in must come out. Ah, ignorance truly is bliss. Well, I hope we didn't, make ourselves more vulnerable for attacks by doing that. Metal, will you excuse me for a second? I can't believe we're shaving and using the toilet repeatedly. Gillian, according to the health pot system, you're exceptionally healthy. Good. I've still got a lot I want to do. One more time. Alright, let's call Jamie. Three, 4, 4, 4.
I was just getting to sleep.
Ask out on date. Okay. Let's talk first. Your feelings. Jamie, I'm not sure how to say this, but I really want to make up with you. I want to try again. Please don't say that, Gillian. Right now, I think the two of us are better off apart. I'm sure of it. I don't care if my memory comes back or not. I just want a second chance with you, Jamie. Gillian, I'm just so sick of our hurting each other. Memories are important for any couple. I can't handle a life of lies. Jamie, I need you. I can't live without you. Gillian, how can you say such lies to me? Lies? What are you talking about? I hear you've been making passes at quite a few women. Who the hell's been telling her that? What? Me? You must be kidding. Metal? Have you been... I was only trying to... Don't you dare attack him, Gillian. At least he showed a little concern about me. Oh my god, I can't believe Metal Gear is contacting our wife behind our back. Jamie, we can make our own memories together. Wait, Gillian, I don't know about this right now. Alright, let's talk about our job. Looks like this junker business is more dangerous than I thought it would be. Gillian? But it's still not as bad as boot camp. I'm a lot more relaxed working like this as a junker. Aren't you pushing yourself too hard? Well, it's pretty scary sometimes, but now I've got a definite goal, something to live for. I was really surprised when I heard you become a junker. I'm sorry. It was really hard for me to try to tell you. That's alright. Besides, we live near each other. We can meet anytime. Call me if anything comes up, okay? Alright. Yeah, I thought that we were gonna end the call. I'm like, I'm not done yet. You know, I figured this out after becoming a junker. There's a snatcher inside every one of us. I think it's our own doubts and suspicions which create them.
Oh, jeez.
You may be right. If we all just trusted one another, we could probably drive them out. Of course, trust in itself breeds suspicion. Junkers shouldn't let themselves get so emotional, Jamie says. I suppose you're right. Take care, Gillian. Hey. Jamie, you should probably stay indoors at night. That's when snatchers are most active. It's dangerous. I'll be fine, Gillian. Where would they ever go after me? They only want VIPs, right? Maybe we used to be VIPs. Maybe we're snatchers now. I never hear that kind of talk from anybody else. Never seen one of these things either. Trust me, there are snatchers in this city. You just don't notice them. That's their plan. That's really frightening. If what you say is true, then you can't trust anybody, can you? It would be even worse than the STBO scare. They exist, Jamie. That's why I'm a junker, like I said. Ask about Jamie's condition. So how are you doing? I'm getting by all right. How about you, Gillian? Are you eating properly? Yeah, I'm doing okay. I miss your great Paschetti, though. Paschetti? Well, that's cute. You still call it that? Same as always, keeping myself busy so the loneliness doesn't have time to sink in. Staying busy at work really helps me. The days pass quickly that way. I wonder what she does for work. Work? How's your job going, Jamie? Are you still working at Kobe Pharmaceuticals? Well, there's our answer. Yes, this work really suits me. I almost feel like I've been doing it for years. Maybe you have. I'm surprised how you keep up in such a technical field. It surprises even me. I guess I still remember some of what I used to know. I'm hoping that doing this job may help bring my memory back. Any sign your memory may be coming back? I'm afraid not. I can't remember anything about living together with you or having fun together. What about you, Gillian? It's the same for me. I can't remember anything from before I woke up in that bed in the Army hospital. That's how we came to, huh? I guess this is going to take some time. I suppose the key is to just keep working at this job and see what happens. This dialogue is really great, just gotta say. Has anything funny happened to you lately? Gillian, if I was a snatcher, could you kill me? Why are you asking me questions like that? Well? I don't know. I really don't. I've always liked that part of your personality. But Gillian, be careful. It could get you killed in that job you're doing. Well, I have too, but everybody's treating it like UFOs or the Loch Ness Monster. Nobody believes it. They say it's just a creation of the mass media. Maybe it's better they think that. Oh, I'm sorry. After all, you are a junker, aren't you? Sure am. Dream. I'm gonna ask about Negligé. What kind of dreams have you had lately? Are you still seeing that same one? Yes, it's that same one over and over. That one, huh? Yes, I'm carrying a child and running from a fire. Could be a repressed memory. But no matter how much I run, the fire doesn't get any farther away. Then what? It gets hotter and hotter until I can't stand it. Then I leave the child and run. You leave the child? And the flames grow brighter and grow and grow? And what about the kid? The child is as cold as ice. Why don't you record that thing for me with the dream recorder? Why? I want to see the same dream as you? No, I hate that dream. I wouldn't want anyone else to see it. But Jamie, it might have something to do with our past. Gillian, I'm really sorry, but I have to hang up now. Sorry. Don't hang up! I was gonna ask you out. Damn it. I have to manually dial a number every time, even though Metal Gear remembers it. 3, 9 3, 4, 4, 4 Did she take it off the hook? It would appear that the line is busy. Ah, damn it. One more try. She really didn't want us to record that dream. Well, for her to record that dream. Damn it, Jamie. Alright. So try back later. She always appears rather pretty. What's with you? Do you want this picture or something? That will not be necessary. I recorded your video phone call to her. Watch it, buddy. That's my wife, you know. Well, it is my duty to record all the details of the investigation. You're really a disgusting little creep, you know. Oh, jeez. Gillian, what sort of an act is this? Why are you pretending? I know you have already called her. That's funny. Okay. I guess we're leaving. We should end our break and get back to the investigation. Alright, I'm ready for another round. Try again. It's ringing! She finally put the phone back on the hook. Head again?
Hi, Jamie speaking. Oh, Gillian, how are you?
I didn't get to ask about your negligee. Never mind, we just talked to her like a minute ago. See if she says anything different. Alright. If those snatches are as bad as they say you are, as you say they are. Don't ask about the dream. Oh, it's not even on there. Destination. Jamie, where are you headed? Oh, I just have an appointment with someone. A man? Why do you want to know? That means yes. Well, you know, I just like to keep tabs on you. You jealous? Aha! That's it. You're jealous, aren't you? Don't pick on me like that. Sorry, and don't worry about anything. I'm just going for my regular examination. What, your memory recovery treatments? That's right. Dr. You-Know-Who. So that's it, huh? Well, that old guy definitely doesn't give me anything to worry about. Now notice she doesn't say the name, otherwise we could look the doctor up in the computer. Jordan. But without a name, can't look it up. I don't know about that. These days I find myself attracted to senior citizens. What? Oh really? Well then I guess I'll have to try again after I've gotten a little older, huh? Before I ask out on a date, let me show up possessions. Check out my ID. That's really nice. Now you finally have something to identify yourself with. Money! Oh, Gillian, I'm not having any money problems now. I've got a good job. Don't worry about me. See if she says anything else. Scrap of paper. Search the house. What's that supposed to mean? Wow, that's a real antique key, isn't it? Gillian, I'm heading out right now. Sorry, I have to hang up. Wait! I wanted to show you more items repeatedly. Get back here. You mean this isn't a mobile phone? What the hell kind of future is this? Not in service?
The number you have reached is not in service at this time.
I hit the wrong number, didn't I?
The number and dial again. This is a recording. JT&T Neo Kobe.
Yeah. Make sure we dial it correctly. 3-9. I think I might have hit 6444. She really did leave. Wow. There was no answer. That's our video phone simulator. Love this music. Alright, let's head to Jean's house then. Gibson's house. Alright, now heading to Jean-Jacques Gibson's house. Might have been named... The last name Gibson might have been from, the author of Neuromancer. We have arrived. This is Gibson's house. Alright, I'm gonna do a couple things. I'm gonna save. I don't even know. Look around. It's a rather nice-looking early American-type home. There's light coming from the windows. This is the northern part of the suburbs. There's quite a contrast between this and the southern district. Secondary lines here. The door on the front is the main entrance. There does not appear to be a doorbell. How about if we try knocking? It's a rather nice-looking early American-type home. Oh, I thought it was in... Investigate. The windows are securely sealed. The glass appears to be of a reinforced type. I read motion. Someone is inside. It is built as a replica of a classic wood-constructed house. So there's motion inside. Who would be inside Jean's house? Jean is dead. The roads and sidewalks are well maintained. Let's try her one more time. Maybe she's back from her appointment. Who knows how long it took for us to drive over there, right? I didn't get to show her my other evidence things. She's back in her negligee.
Oh, is that you, Gillian? I was just getting to sleep.
Alright. What do you think about this stuff? Chess piece. That's a chess piece. That's all you got, Jamie? I guess so. A floppy disk? Jeez, I haven't seen one of those in ages. Let's ask you about the negligee. So, Jamie, what's under that negligee? What are you talking about, Gillian? Well, you know, I bet you're not wearing anything. Of course not. I don't wear any underwear when I sleep. Aha! So that means, he thinks to himself. Jamie, look out! There's a big roach on your bed! Ah! Where? It just went under the sheets. Really? Yeah, you better pull those sheets off quickly or... Where? Where is it? Hurry, Jamie! Oh! I can't stand this! Ah! Where is it? Jamie, you've got to pull those sheets back quickly. The sheets, everything, pull it all off. Jamie? Jamie? Gillian? There's no roach, is there? You never change, do you? Sorry. She went to an appointment to improve her memory, so I thought she would say something else about that. Alright, she's gonna say no, but... Oh! We could ask her to date to multiple different things. Meal? I guess dinner? Musical, zoo, ocean, amusement park, races, hotel, or arcade? About the ocean? That sounds nice. Jamie, let's go to the beach. Where should we go? How about Ashiya Bay? Or Old Suma? Wait, I know. Let's go to Mako Park. It's sealed off, but I know a back way in. It'll be okay. I have my junker pass. Besides, it's an all-weather type beach. It won't be that cold. I'm sorry, Gillian, but you know I hate wearing swimsuits. You're scarred from having your appendix out, right? When are you ever going to stop worrying about that? Plus, you can wear a one-piece. I'm sorry, Gillian. I just don't feel like doing that kind of thing yet. Okay, how about to the zoo? Why don't we visit the bio zoo? I hear a baby unicorn's been born over there. And I hear there's an exhibition of works by the Karmeisenhaufen. I'm sorry, Gillian. Jamie, please. I'm sorry. Well, that's her saying, I'm sorry. Can't help? Come on, Jamie. Talk to me a bit. Over dinner or something. We haven't been out in so long. Let's try out that new anti-gravity ride at Neo Portopia Land. We need to relax. That'll really help us forget about work. And I hope you wear a skirt when we go. I'm sorry, Gillian, etc. Okay. No idea? Okay, we're running out of ideas. Musical. Jamie, how about a musical? There's some really interesting robot musicals playing. How about Phantom of the Opera? Sorry, it's in a room. Let's go see dragon horses. You've always liked horses, right? Besides, the Arima Cup is coming up pretty soon. I'm not gonna say anything, but I just want to see all the dialogue options. When we choose one thing, she'll be like, yes, I'm going. Why don't we share a quiet drink over in the lounge at the Neo Portopia Hotel? Jamie, you've always liked moonsault, right? Arcade. Why don't we head over to the Hoverland Arcade? It's a lot bigger than Mindwave, and there's a lot of couples there these days. I'll grab a cute stuffed animal for you with one of those superconducting cranes. I'm good friends with one of the employees over there, so I can always get prizes. Last but hopefully not least, the aquarium. How about the virtual reality aquarium? I hear it seems like you're really walking on water. Plus, in the winter, they always have that special Jaws hunt event going. You won't have to wear a swimsuit there. We don't even have the option, though. She's hanging up. It's alright, we're out of options anyway. Okay. Alright. Stay tuned for our next episode when we knock on the door and try to get into Jean's house. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you in the next episode. And always, seek adventure.